You're watching Radio Borgen with the Far Side. This is Imani on y'all side live in Oslo. What's happening?
Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Radio Borgen. We're here backstage at John D with the Pharcyde. You guys want to introduce yourself?
Yo, Slim Kid Trey.
Fat Lip.
Imani, what's happening?
Hey, so thank you for such a great show. Can I take you back to the roots, really, how you guys met?
Yeah. Oh, shit. Man, how we met? Shit, that's so fucking long ago, man. Look, man, what really matters is exactly what's happening right now. So, okay, look, I went to college at this place called El Camino, and I went to his high school graduation. So that's as far back as I'm going to say for y'all, all right, because it's all about what's happening right now in the future. So all the young kids out there, if you haven't heard Bizarre Ride to the Far Side, go out and get it, you know what I'm saying? I know all your big brothers and big sisters, they already got the stuff, you know what I'm saying? It's 30 years. This is our 30-year anniversary, man. So you know what I mean? If there's any historical stuff you want to check out, go to the Pharcyde Lives on YouTube or the Pharcyde Lives on Instagram. You know what I mean? It will keep you updated about stuff. But you guys got to dig in the archives if you want to know the history of some shit.
Yeah, you're speaking about the future, and I think we should focus on that. Yeah. Present time? Yeah, we should talk about present time and forward. The next show is in Bristol. Yeah, and how long are you guys on tour?
We're on tour for, I don't know, like a week, another week and a half or something like that, right?
April 1st.
Yeah, we rocking. We got, we're gonna be in Spain. We killing it, man. UK, shit. We in Oslo right now. Shit was lit last, tonight. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you like the crowd?
Best show so far.
Yeah.
So far, you're saying this just because we're here, huh?
I don't kiss ass, zero ass kiss. You know what I mean?
It was a great crowd, though. No, it's always a good crowd, man.
Copenhagen or Amsterdam. Yeah. Amsterdam's hard to beat, man.
Just to keep it real. Man. I mean, tonight was cool, but nah. Copenhagen was liver than this, and Amsterdam is the standard.
After 30 years of doing this, do you ever really get nervous before you hop on stage?
You know what? I used to get nervous when I hopped on stage, but I figured out, like, ain't nobody got time for that. So we can't be doing that shit, man. We got a show to do, you know what I'm saying? I get it. Cause like, I mean, like when you get nervous, like for the stage, you always gotta go pee, or you always gotta go take a shit. And then after you take a shit and you pee, you gotta do it again. So it's just like, it's mind over matter kind of situation. And you literally don't have time. Like this is your moment.
Have it been in like vomit on my sweater already type moment?
Nah, I don't vomit on my shit. You know what I'm saying?
Mom's spaghetti? No.
You never get nervous.
Nah, we've been doing this shit for so long. And then it's hard to get nervous cause the fans, they want it. They, you know what I mean? They coming out to support and they show them so much love. Not just for us, just for hip hop in general. You know what I'm saying? It's just like a resurgence of, you know, our era. This shit, like you said, it's 30 years old, but you know, it's got some, I mean, it's probably some people that was not even born in 92 that's at the show. Shit.
See, I wasn't born in 92.
That's what I'm saying. So
Pharcyde Lives, your YouTube channel, right?
The Pharcyde Lives is our YouTube channel as well as our Instagram channel. If you go to just the Pharcyde by itself, you won't be able to get in touch with the originators. The Pharcyde Lives is where you can find us. Go like and subscribe and hit the ring button.
There's a little bell on the corner.
You gotta hit the fucking bell, you know what I mean?
Hit the fucking bell, man.
Hit the fucking bell. But seriously, that's where we're gonna keep, you know, uploading new content and things like that. We're making new music and the whole deal, so you guys get ready for it.
Yeah, I wanna ask you guys. Yeah, it's 3 years since last you were in Norway, yeah? How long we... Yeah, it's 3 years.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I triple checked that shit.
Don't worry about it.
But I'm wondering, how long are we gonna wait till you come back, yeah?
Next month, we're gonna be back.
We came here to let it be known that we're open for business, so maybe we can come back and more fans will spread the word and we can get more money and it'll be like a bigger event and we can, like, you know, do other things, maybe come with another artist, Souls of Mischief or Hieroglyphics. Yeah. Or...
Speaking about Souls of Mischief, because they're coming to Norway in the end of the month, and I know you guys made an album together.
I talk to Opio every day this whole tour, and like, we're back and forth, so.
But are there any collabs coming in the future that we can look
for? Collab? No, we're trying to figure out our own record. I mean, no, we've been working, but it's just like the music business has changed so different. You feel me? We don't have a deal.
How?
Because the internet and technology. It went from needing people to put music out to just like, there's music everywhere, whether SoundCloud or, it's like a different thing. thing, and we're not from this era. So it's like we're not from the internet age. We're trying to figure shit out.
Yeah,
you feel me?
Yeah.
Because some people's like, just put it out. But it's like, we need some money. So it's a lot of moving parts. So we're just trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
But we're appreciative for everybody that's still like rocking with us. It's 30 years later.
Yeah. And I wanted to ask you guys, since you've been in the game so long, do you think it's easier now to make it as a rapper?
When you say make it, what do you mean?
Do you think it's easier now when it's easier to like publish your music and you can just throw it?
Oh, it's easier to put music out. It's not easier to make a profession of it, no. I think it's very difficult. I think everything is individual on the person. It depends on what you're... because some people are trying to make money if they come in with a business. Some people are just like having fun.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I can't speak for anybody but myself. Like, I'm only speaking for myself. For me, it's different. I roll with the punches.
Do you have anything you want to say to the youth in Norway who wants to start rapping?
Start rapping? Yeah, do it. You gotta give it 110%. Because it's not, like we were saying, it's not easy. Take a little bit of luck, but it take a whole lot of blood, sweat, and tears, and dedication, but it's worth it. You know what I'm saying?
Know why you're doing it. Because some people think they want to be a celebrity, and they may not. Some people think they want to do it to make money. Some people may not. Know what your reason is for doing it, and then it'll make your trip a little bit easier.
To bring it all down, you were speaking about your mentor.
Yeah.
Can you speak some more on that relationship?
Yeah. Reggie Andrews, we were lucky enough to meet him. He was a teacher at Locke High School, but before that, he was a producer, and he produced for the Dazz Band, Rick James, and a lot of 70s and 60s funk groups and stuff like that. When we met him in the 90s, he had established this workshop where you can learn the music industry and learn the craft of producing and writing songs and shit like that. That's where we all met. I was a solo artist. They had a group, but it was like, it was a bunch of kids there. This was at his house. And so he introduced us to many people that were helping us. Like, for instance, Sarita Wright, who wrote Signed, Sealed, Delivered, Stevie Wonder's first hit. She was his wife. People like that. And Dugu Chandler played drums for Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
These are the people that he brought us around. Like, we would have meetings every Monday, and he would have people come in and tell us about the industry and shit like that. So that was Reggie, and then every record. We went into his garage one day and saw some crates, and then all of those crates, those records, ended up being all of the shit that you heard on our first album. We found it was like a gold mine and shit. The shit was crazy.
For this last segment, we have actually brought some gifts to you guys. Yeah, this for you. We got some for all the guys.
Oh, thank you.
What? The Lok is the prime hat shop in Norway. You gotta open it up, man.
Boxing. Always wanted this shit. Yeah. No way. Oh,
so these are our Radio Borgen hats.
Shit.
So, bless, man, take it with you.
Thank you, bro.
Thank you so much for the interview, man. Such a nice experience.
Rock-a-bye, baby. Listen to your heartbeat pumping to a fine. Ravine of all things, it's the vein of a shrine. Omissions impossible, a possible consignment.